Hold the presses. Hold on. Hold on. All right. Now, before we begin this video, I need to disclose some things. Okay. First off, I did the entire video, and well, discovered at the very end, well, I had made some fatal flaws, right, affecting the sound of the cabinet and speaker. And that is, I was impatient and wanted to try out the cabinet as quickly as possible, right? And so I just used screws that were around, you know. And, well, they hold down the speaker okay, but one was missing, right? I think it was stripped out or something. Or maybe I just didn't have a screw that was big enough. But as a result, it affected the sound greatly, because I was getting kind of a cabinet rattle, I thought. Right? There's just something didn't sound quite right, especially at louder volumes, you know. To handle the real deep bass. Well, as it turns out, that screw, missing screw, made all the difference in the world. So I want to let you know, when you watch this video, especially the audio examples, right, it'll give you an idea. But I believe that the cabinet and speaker can do a lot more and sound a lot better. Once those screws that hold down the speaker are put in correctly, you know, and quite frankly, well, I need to go to the hardware store and get some better screws. And, you know, on a guitar speaker, it doesn't make all that big a difference. But my goodness, on a bass speaker, it makes a huge difference. I mean, gigantic. And the reason is because you're handling, you know, such low frequencies, right? And they rattle everything, right? And in fact, you'll see in the video when I discover this, because I'm thinking, wait a minute, there's some kind of cabinet rattle, so something must be loose in the cabinet or something. And then I discover, you'll see, that when I press down where the missing screw is, oh, well, all of a sudden the rattle goes away. All right, so keep that in mind when you're watching this video, and we're going to do a part three, because I don't think I'm doing justice to what this cab and speaker are capable of. Okay, so once I get it, you know, really tied down, you know, with better screws, you know, it'll probably sound a lot better. So just keep that in mind, okay? And, I mean, this is kind of, you know, par for the course. I mean, when you first get a cabinet, especially when you're putting together like this, you know, you're going to go through this kind of thing until you get it just the way you want it. So you might hear some rattling and things, you know, especially at louder volumes, that are basically my fault because I didn't you know, tie down the speaker, which I will do, of course, and then we'll do a part three. Okay, so just keep in mind. Anyway, this will give you an idea, though, of what it'll sound like, basically. But I think we can do better. You know, I would have never guessed that one little screw, right, would make such a gigantic difference. Wow. And I mean, that's just, you know, because guitar speakers are very forgiving because they don't handle much low end, really. A little bit, you know, but not like anything like this kind of thing. You know, on a guitar speaker, I mean, you can put two or three screws in and you're good to go. But here, that's just not the case at all. You know, and I mean, I had seven screws in that thing. You think that would take care of it, but no. So, just keep that in mind when you're watching the video. All right, roll it! Hello, YouTubers. I want to welcome you to another edition of Parking Bin Gear. And you'll have to excuse me, we're improvising here because it's raining out. Okay, now, I hope you're subscribing and following the channel, because we did a part one of this bass cabinet, PV bass cabinet with a PV 15-inch speaker, right? But it was kind of empty, it didn't have any input jacks and things. So, one other thing it didn't have were cables. Or speaker wire, if you like, you know. And I mean, I didn't want to mess around making a little panel and things, so I went looking around, you know, online, and I discovered a panel that might fit. It's a 5x7 panel with two input jacks and a speak-on. Two quarter-inch input jacks and a speak-on connector. And a speak-on connector is very handy because if somebody steps on it or something, it won't disconnect, basically. So pretty heavy duty. And the panels were pre-wired. Wow! What a time saver for me. You know, it means no soldering or anything. Pretty much ready to go, you know. Now, there's a caveat here, and it makes sense usually, not for this particular project, but in general, and that is you have to buy two of them, right? So you get two panels, and you can't buy just one, of course. And well, usually that makes sense because it's, you know, usually in stereo, right? You've got two of them. But in this case, I only have one. Because it's going to be a bass amp, or a bass emulation amp, if you like. You know, well, it's here. Let's have an unboxing. Wow. Oh, and the cost, I forgot. Very important. $17.99 delivered. Okay, that's really not bad, especially for two panels. And I'm sure when it comes down to it, somewhere down the road, I'm going to need a very similar panel. Now, okay, I did some small measurements just to see if it would fit, and I think it does. So here we go, we're going to have an unboxing. And it's quite heavy, I'm quite surprised. Here it is. Now please don't try this at home. Only trained professionals should attempt. I've heard of horror stories of people getting maimed because they tried to do an unboxing and were not trained professionals. Okay, here we go. So there it is, white box. Wow. Let's see what we get here. Well, I'll be darned. Boy, these are heavy duty. A lot more than I thought. I thought it'd be like a little plastic panel. No, not at all. Look at this. In its own bubble wrap sheath. Okay. Oh my goodness. And that wire is pretty heavy duty too. Look at this. Here it is. So for our purposes, it'll fit kind of like that. We'll see. And, metal. Okay, good. Man, look at this wiring, though. I mean, that is awesome. And that'll be certainly enough to reach the jacks on the speaker itself. Pretty heavy duty. Look at that. I mean, this isn't like cheapo tiny wiring. Right? Very nice. Two jacks. It's all pre-wired. So basically just pop it in and you're good to go if it fits. Alright, so I took a look at it and it's not an exact match. Okay? And it may take a little bit of drilling to get some screws in there. I think we can make this work. It's going to be real close. The problem is the hole, you know, and the amp is a little bit bigger side to side. Up and down it works fine. Side to side it's just off a little tiny bit. I think we can make this work. Alright, and I'll show you that. You know, right now it's raining, so don't want to get it outside and things. But I'll show you that and show you how it eventually was mounted. And we'll go from there. Alright, very good. Now, one thing I should mention is that it does not come with any mounting screws whatsoever. So you've got to provide the mounting screws, which in this case is no problem at all, because I've got to get some mounting screws for the speakers. I ran out, and we're going to improvise to get this panel on, so I may need some different screws. We'll see. I think this is going to work, though. Here, I'll try and show you. Hold on. Alright, now here's the back of the cabinet, and I'm surprised you can see anything at all. It's kind of hard to see. But anyway, so here's the panel we're going to put in, right here. And as you can see, well, it'll just go right through there, right? Oops. So it's not quite big enough. However, check this out. If, right here, oops. Okay, if we get the edge there and the edge at the bottom, well, that's gonna stay on, see? See that? And let me get these wires out of the way. Alright, so it's going to be close, but we're going to have to, I think, put a nail there and a nail there, or screw, I mean, and get it to work that way. But it's real close. It's what I was expecting, in fact, you know, but I did not find anything closer than this, so, and it's pre-wired, which is very nice. I won't have to rewire the thing. Now one thing I could do is take it to the side and that will fit. Leaves a space though on the other side, so we'll see. We'll see. So quite a few different options there. We'll see what happens as far as mounting it. Okay, now let me tell you what happened here. Here's the cabinet. Right, and there's the PV speaker installed, and then on the back I installed the panel as well. Well, temporarily, I guess. I could adjust it if I wanted to. In any case, so I wanted to see what this thing could do, you know. And so I had sound for a little bit, and I pushed it a little hard, and no sound. Complete fail. Man, I thought, oh no, I blew the speaker. Oh, that sucks. Right? I just blew the speaker right out. No good. Because I wasn't getting any sound. I only had it for a couple minutes. Well, let me tell you why it failed. As it turns out, the speaker's fine. It's okay. You know? Because, I mean, I was going to diss that speaker and say, oh, well, PV Neo, PV Poo Poo. But it's not at all. What happened was, the bass was so powerful, because I was really pushing the speaker to see what it could do, that it knocked the little speaker leads off the speaker, so it wasn't getting a signal. So I'm going to have to go in there. The truth is, really what it should be is those, they really need to be soldered. Because when you're dealing with those kinds of bass levels, you know, you really have to change that out. Anyway, so I, you know, took the panel off and put the leads back on, the wire leads back onto the speaker. And I'm pleased to announce that we have sound again. So the speaker's not blown, that's great. Let's hear it. Okay, now the things I'm listening for here is to see if I'm getting any rattles or anything like that. You know, especially when you're handling the low volume like that. I mean, that's a big low end right there. Right? And I'm hearing a tiny bit, but not too bad. Through and tighten the screws, you know, on all the cabinet parts. You know? But I mean, listen to that. That's violent. Big, big sound there. And it can take more. I'll push it a little. Now that I know that I can. Okay. So let's give this a try here. And remember, this is for my looping setup. And I mean, I can hear the fan from the little PA cabinets here. I'm running through the PV600G. You know. Alright, let's try this. There's the guitar part. It's real simple.
Thank you. thing. Oops. Alright, so here's a loop with the bass. Sound, but it's way in the background because of the crossover to protect those guitar speakers. Doesn't even sound like bass, but let's turn on the PA again, the PB. PB is doing its job. Now, here are my overall thoughts. One, overall, I have spent $17 on this cabinet and speaker for the little panel. And let me tell you, it's great. It's super. And I pushed it, pretty hard to see how far it could go, sound-wise. And I forgot, there's one more test we can do. I'm just curious to see how it sounds with the synthesizer. Okay. So again, I had, you know, $17 invested, right? And it's great. It really works well. Now, if you push it too far, you know, it can start to rattle a little bit and those kinds of things. Okay, now I want to show you something. Take a listen to this. But instead, it's because I didn't do it right. Look, watch. I'm missing a screw here. So watch what happens when I push down. Ah, no rattle. Okay, so that's actually really great news. Because it's not the cabinet. And it's not even the speaker. It's my mounting. So I'm going to have to get a screw that fits. The reason it has no screw is the screw I had did not fit very well there. And so it's causing that rattle. There's a few things you could do, you know, tightening up screws and those kinds of things. Isolating where it's rattling and things. Now, one thing to keep in mind, and this I totally forgot about. Remember, this is a PA speaker. This is not a bass speaker. Okay, ideally, you know, you could spend, you know, and I looked up some, just to see what the cost would be for a bass speaker, you know, a 15-inch bass speaker, a decent one. And I mean, you're talking $140, $150. I just don't want to do that. And this goes a long way as far as bass sounds. And I'm always stunned, you know, when I turn off the PA head, you know. I'm like, oh my gosh, where's the bass, you know? Now, I can't say it's the most efficient speaker, you know, compared to the guitar speakers. And I think one of them's a Cannabis Rex, and it's like, the sensitivity is like 102 dB or something like that. Something like that. In other words, it's very efficient. I don't find that as much in the PA speaker here. But it's perfectly usable. You know. Now, how does it compare with the Hartke bass amp? The HD150, which is my favorite. I mean, that's a really powerful sound. It's close, okay? It's very close. However, you know, because the Hartke has a bass speaker for bass, you know. I mean, the Hartke's a little better, but I mean, that's to be expected, you know. But as far as a PA cabinet, is really great. I'm very, very pleased, you know. Now, will I be putting a bass speaker in it? Yeah. I don't know. I'm not sure I want to do that either, you know. That'd be another $150. You know, and for my purposes, this will work for sure, you know. And now keep in mind, you know, if for my setup and things, you know, I'll have to work with it a little bit and you know, get the volumes balanced and those kinds of things, you know. So there you go. What a deal, man. Very, very pleased and quite impressed with the sound, you know. So there you go. And I mean, for a PA speaker, it handles a ton of bass. You know, there's no question about that. Just I think, you know, obviously a bass speaker would can it handle more than that? And then you can get into subwoofers, and you know, it's kind of endless. But there's a cost involved, and for right now, I sure like the price of $17 more than I do $150, you know. And it gave me such a scare when I was pushing it really hard, and then all of a sudden, no sound. Right? I was like, oh man. Did I just push it too hard and blew the speaker? But no, it was the vibrations knocked the little wires off the speaker, you know? So, probably solder those in would probably be the best deal. You know, I guess you could crimp them a little better. But I'm very pleased, you know. I mean, you can understand. For a, you know, a cabinet I was going to throw away, and now it's very useful. Kind of as a base cabinet, really. Yeah, very nice. Very nice. All right, very good. See you next time. Okay, bye.